with LSD. I don't know if you've ever seen one of those, but you can tell what they are. And so I kind of walked over to him and I took it from him. And then I turned around to our drummer and I was like, ah. And I turned around and I,
what?
And I put the rest in my pocket, right? And it's true. And if, about a half hour later, right, I was tripping balls in our light show. We don't even have a light show, man. And I was jamming out, because I'm in a jam band. I mean, I don't play the guitar, so I just mostly just have to do this, you know. And I was having a great time, and I thought I sounded terrific. Nobody complained. Everybody seemed to have a good time. So, but then the next night, right, we go down to Los Angeles, and we were supposed to play at the House of Blues, and we were staying in a hotel right across from there. And being then, like, we don't, hadn't showered in a while, so I thought, fuck, I best should do that, you know. I go to, and I find the rest of that vial in my shirt. And what's the phrase? If something's good, more is better, right? So, I was like, I did the rest. And jumped in the shower, and then I don't know what's in there, because I must have stayed in there long enough for it to work, and maybe it was like hot water or whatever. But then when I went to get out, the door moved, right? So to the right, so I couldn't get out. And I don't know if you ever talk about the LSD, but it makes it so stuff like that happens, but it doesn't make you mad. You're like, ah. So I'm like walking around the shower going, this door is jacked. I finally get out of the shower and I get dressed for the gig and I go to leave my room. Same fucking thing. And I'm like, oh, it's gonna be door night. You know, I'm like, here we go. So again, it takes me like 10 minutes of like chasing this door. I'm laughing about it. I'm sweating again already. I probably had my eyes were pretty pumpkin, and I get out of my room and I get down into the lobby and I go to leave the building. Same fucking issue. So I'm moving with the door and the doorman, right? I've never thought of that title as linear as I considered it that night. And I was like, then you gotta get me out of here, man. So the next thing I know, I'm standing on the sidewalk and I can see the fucking House of Blues. That's where I have to go to sing with my group. I don't know how I didn't end up going over there, man. I didn't go over there. I don't know how I ended up pretty, not that far away, but far enough away to not remember where I was or what I was trying to remember. And I was just walking around Hollywood and having fun, but knew I was missing something, or that I was supposed to be doing something. And I've had this motto my whole life, it's helped me my whole life, which is this: when in doubt, give up. That's not what I mean. I use it in doubt. So I see these two fucking guys sitting by a liquor store, you know how guys do? So I sit next to them, and they didn't mind, and the cars are going by, and people are going by, tourists and shit are going by. And then I see this young couple coming up the street, and they're like, they're staring at me, so I'm staring at them. And when they get close, the girl says, aren't you Todd Snyder? And I said, yeah, but where though, you know? And I was so relieved, I remember going, oh, thank God. And she looked at me funny, because like, but where is a funny question to ask. And she said, my boyfriend and I were going to see your band play. And I was like, you gotta take me with you to that thing. So, here comes the helpful part, right? So we get to the show and I see the band and I'm like, we can't do this, you guys. I've gone too far. I can't do the songs. There's no way. And the band was like, that's not how it works in jail. We're doing this. And so I didn't know how I was supposed to fucking get through it. I'm like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. Here's the help. And our piano player, Chad Staley, he said that a banana helps. That's the helpful part of the story. Is that if you take too much acid, a banana helps. Now, I didn't buy it at first, and then he went in and got one, handed me a fucking formula, it worked. And if you can go on your computer and see the show is on there, we rip it down. We were terrific. I held that banana the whole fucking time, too. And so play the song that after Chad had said to me that if I had eaten the banana, it would have helped even more than it did. So it's something to consider, you know. If you ever in that spot. Conservative Christian, right-wing Republican, straight white American male. Soul-saving flag waving, rush loving and feeding, regional leaders of sales. Shirt tucking, frat house and kick tapping, backslapping hater, hippies like me. Tree hugging, peace loving, pot smoking, porn watching, lazy ass hippies like me. Tree hugging, peace loving, pro choice and gay wedding, hardworking American hippies like me. Skin color blinded, conspiracy minded, protesters of corporate greed. We do have nothing and most likely will, until we all end up locked up in jails. By conservative Christian, right-wing Republican, straight white American man. Diamonds and dogs, boys and girls, we're living together in two separate worlds. We're following leaders of mountains of shame. We look at each other with blame. I know I enjoy blaming. Conservative Christian, right-wing Republican, straight white American male. Gay bats and black fear and war fighting, tree killing, personal friends to the quail. Working so hard to keep the free reins of this democracy. From tree again, peace loving, pot smoking, porn watching, lazy ass hippies like me. Tree hugging, peace loving, pot smoking, porn watching, lazy ass hippies like me. Over and over again that only half of you